Here's some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Hugo Boss after the German fashion house cuts its full-year sales outlook amid persistent macroeconomic and geopolitical challenges. Hugo Boss shares plunged 8%. Also in focus, shares of Ocado after the British online grocer reported a lower first-half loss and raised its full-year guidance. Ocado shares jumped 11.5% in midday trading. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of United Health Group, which reported better-than-expected profit for the second quarter. The stock, though, is down 2.4% in pre-market trading.
Asian markets closed mostly lower despite more dovish comments from Fed Chief Jerome Powell overnight. This is as investors continue to assess a possible Trump victory in the U.S. The Hong Kong Hang Seng led declines, falling another 1.5%. Here at home, the local bourse snapped a three-session win streak, with the main index shedding a third of 8%.
If you're going to look at the relative stock indices, first, if you're going to look at the general market, it's been moving upward, but it hasn't reached the overbought territory yet, which means that, you know, there's momentum, at least price action-wise, there's momentum for the general market. If you're going to look at the sub-indices, all of them are also biased towards the upside. If you're going to look at their relative strength index, meaning all are seen to have positive momentum. The only index that is seen to have reached overbought territory is the property index.
Okay.
So that's with respect to the RSI. The RSI so far is telling us that many of the stocks in the market are showing positive momentum.
A notable stock movement in the region, shares of Ping An Insurance tumbled more than 5% on worries over potential share dilution. That's after China's biggest insurer announced a $3.5 billion convertible bond sale. The ASEAN Plus 3 Macroeconomic Research Office, or AMRO, downgrades its economic outlook for the Philippines for this year and the next. For 2024, it expects Philippine GDP to hit 6.1%, lower than its previous estimate of 6.3%. For next year, the growth projection is down from the previous 6.5% to 6.3%. AMRO says the Philippine government needs to address the infrastructure gap and attract more investments to boost economic growth. Meanwhile, the group also revised downwards its inflation outlook for the country this year from 3.6% to 3.3%. In the whole ASEAN Plus 3 region, AMRO retained its 4.4% estimate for 2024 and 4.3% in 2025, owing to favorable export prospects, firm domestic demand, and continued tourism recovery.
As you can see from the table, we have shaved down the growth for not just the Philippines, but many of the countries in the region. Because as it turns out, you know, as I mentioned, the recovery in the external sector was weaker than expected. On the other hand, we think the Philippines, you know, growth is pretty robust and will pick up next year to 6.3%. So this is well within, I think, the official range of 6 to 7%. We are on the low side, but we look at the data closely, and you know, indeed, and we may revise it up if the second half.